Guys, we're going to be underway. I'm going to click this button.
Welcome.
And I believe that we have the titles correct. I'll be making sure that's correct at the top of your guys' screen. You will see winner bracket round of eight. This is game one of five over to the right side for the red team, the attacking team, for the first time here on Hollywood. Round of eight going to be the side of TSM. On the left side is going to be Oh No. We'll go ahead and get into the players' introductions. But of course, guys, it's been a long break. A bit of a minute or so before I've gotten to talk about Overwatch, but 3-2 was the victory for Oh No. They were able to take out the side of Northern Gaming Red, and it was definitely a victory that on paper a lot of people would have not expected. And I'm not going to lie, I might have a slight bias throughout this cast. I have played against FactFiction in Dota, and definitely rooting for them to continue to make it through, but their challenge, their opponent, is one of the strongest of the bracket. Mopark, he's going to be picking up a Zarya for the side at 411 level. Going to be picking up that Zarya. No golden Zarya gun. I'm a little disappointed. Chase Hill going to be over here on a Reaper. We have Mofit for the side of Oh No as well. Going to be picking up a McCree. Zayd is going to be picking up the Zenyatta. We have FactFiction over here on his good old Reinhardt. And then Rockus, last but not least, is going to be Lucio. Over here for the side of the offense, for the side of TSM, definitely. That's pretty cool. Definitely the stronger team on paper here, without any question. It's going to be JKW picking up the Reinhardt, all familiar names. Shape going to be on his Zenyatta. Torque, first of the TJO brothers, going to be picking up the McCree. Joe Meister on a Lucio. Nicholas TJO going to be picking up the Reaper. And then last but not least is going to be Harblue. Definitely made his name as a Roadhog player first and foremost, as his Roadhog play was one of the most terrifying to play against. His flanking potential, his ability to understand the map and read it and get into the good spots. And interesting to see that being the case. Thank you for that information, Ninja. As Esper has been signed to, it looks like H2K, but into this game, as of course we are just in the beginning of it. Torque looking for the shots onto the high ground setup. Defense going to be set up on that cafe. Nothing surprising there. So you can see the spam going out from both sides. There's going to be the offensive push in, though. TSM's going to secure themselves onto the point. Already going to get themselves maybe the first take. Flashbang onto Torque as it looks like a trade. Mofit takes out Torque, but Harblue helps take out Zayd. And it's going to be a 2-for-2 now as Joe Meister helps answer in. And really, this is just going both directions. Mopark doing a lot of damage here on the Zarya. Mofit as well, able to take out Nicholas TJO. And this is going really good for them. Nicholas not able to get the better of that duel. And Mofit, 3 kills on the match. And gotta say, if they beat Northern Gaming Red, there were probably some players that were stepping up above their weight class, is probably the way to say it. And Mofit looks like to be the one off the bat, getting himself 3 kills for his team and doing a good job as well. Guys, do let me know if there's any issues with the stream, any production errors, any sound errors. Do let me know so I can get them fixed up before the series gets too far in. But looks like all JKW able to take out Mofit. And Mofit was a critical member for the previous side. Chase waiting. Now he's going to go in. Does get a good shot though, but a great Earth Shatter coming up from JKW. He's going to charge onto FactFiction, taking him out. Chase need to be able to take out JKW if they're going to go ahead and win this, but he gets taken out by Torque. And there's going to be the rebuttal from the McCree finally, as he's able to get another kill with his brother Nicholas, taking out Mopark. And now one more hero. Looks like it is going to be Rockus. He gets cleaned up, point taken. 1 minute and 40 seconds needed to do that. As looks like Torque gonna push forward, and Mofit, he's not gonna be able to win that duel this time. Mofit caught a little bit with his pants down there, not ready for that. Torque aggressing forward, looking for some shots onto the Zenyatta of Zay, but not gonna get enough to go ahead and take him out. We're gonna go ahead and take a moment here to look at the ultimate charges of what we got here. We have a Zarya with a Graviton Surge. We have a Deadeye coming out from Mofit. FactFiction switched over to his Zarya, so not close, or to a D.Va, so not gonna be too close to that Earthshatter. And unfortunately, there aren't any streams. That is the case, as Torque is going to get the kill onto Rockus in a second and a down moment. Of course, if you guys explain it in chat, I won't, but we'll find out in a second. Is there going to be an engage going out here? Is there going to be the Graviton Surge going out? Not sure where that ended up landing. Maybe it got absorbed by FactFiction. I don't see any pulsing going out, but there's going to be the Graviton Surge coming out from the side of the defense. Can Oh No capitalize on it? And it looks like it. Kill feed very much blue right now, as the red is on the receiving end of this kill feed. And yeah, right now, guys, Envious has not been streamed. I hopefully will be able to cast some Envious. We'll find out. I've been definitely looking to cast some Seagull, aka Energy Gaming, right now, and Envious, but I did want to cover the matches that weren't going to be as much of the blowouts for the viewing pleasure of this stream. But if you guys want, I can go ahead and get into some Envious next, as of course they will be playing the winner of this next, assuming that they win their match. Torque moving forward. Ultimate's definitely in the favor of the defense right now. Chase Fan favorite over here. A few PogChamps for him and Chad as he's going to push forward with this Dragon Blade. Looking for the slashes onto JKW, but there's going to be a double kill for Mofit. Death Blossom coming out from Nicholas, but nothing going to be done with that, of course, because there is the Transcendence for the defense. Chase going to be getting the kill onto him as Mofit takes out JKW, and right now, the side of TSM is not looking like the same squad that we would have expected on paper. Oh no! Able to take out Northern Gaming Red to get here, and right now, they're looking like a very strong team. Chase Hill, Mofit, this guy right now. Mofit is doing a lot. And we'll see if he can continue to 3 minutes and 42 seconds on the stopwatch, guys. TSM, can they do it? TSM fighting. We'll find out. Mofit taking a fair bit of damage there, but is already up to 75% on his ultimate. We'll be looking for those shots over to the Reinhardt. There's going to be a self-destruct coming out from Fact Fiction. He's going to be able to take out Torque. A little bit of a blunder there from Torque, as you're not supposed to be caught by that. Fact immediately going to get knocked out of the mech as soon as he gets back into it. Earthshadow does come out from JKW, but it doesn't do that much. Mofit, he couldn't pull the trigger before the charge ended up hitting him. He thought about it. You could see, I swear, McCree started to pull the trigger. That's why I freaked out, but it looks like Mopork will end up going down as Shake ends up getting himself a double kill. And that's what you need from your Zenyatta. Harblue in the background gets some kills onto Zayd, and that's going to allow them to go ahead and take the points. So TSM not getting knocked out or not getting stalled up that hard yet, as they will be able to take the second point. 4:30 on the clock to work with. Stopwatch sitting at 4:30, so perfectly mirrored as we are about halfway through from this map. And again, guys, go ahead and get on social media. Let people know about these matches. Let people know about this stream, as well as Twitch.tv/ESL_Overwatch. Plenty of action to watch today, and definitely let people know so they can find the streams themselves, as there's only so much that I can do. Of course, ESL, definitely be watching those streams, as that's where you're going to be finding some of the better games. But here right now, this game is a good one. Oh no, they're having a good time right now, as they're able to stall up pretty well. 3:57 on the clock, but TSM, what can they do here? We'll see multiple ultimates. There's going to be a Dragon Blade coming out of Torque, as Chase Hill just got his up. Torque going to be looking for the deflect. He pulls the trigger, but it doesn't matter because of the Transcendence blocking up the damage. Great movement there from the side of Zayd. And now it looks like the kill feed, though, going over to the side of TSM. Tick. Nicholas able to get himself a double kill. Chase is still alive and getting some kills, but he does end up dying to Harblue in the end. In fact, Fiction going to be able to get himself a kill with that suicide. Does get back into the mech and buying more time. 30 seconds is what he's gotten so far. He could get more as he is up on this catwalk, able to jump down at any point where he wants to. Looks like he is going to push forward down to 30 HP, still in the mech, still slogging out. There's a Graviton Surge from the defense doing a lot of damage. We're getting them at least grouped up. Sorry for that bug, but it should end in just a second as Harblue Shake is able to take out Chase Hill. And right now the kill feed going for TSM as, oh no, losing their footing, losing their teeth, not able to keep up with the fight. There is going to be an Earthshatter going out from JKW, pretty much killing up the rest. That is going to be 1 meter, and that is going to be a cap, but I'm not going to lie, guys, that was a decent time from TSM, but still. It is actually a good match right now. Oh no, are looking very strong right now to surprise a bunch. 6:02 was the time on my stopwatch. And, go ahead and post that out there. Make sure I got the right time. 6:02 is what I had. KK. So guys, that will be the time for the side of Oh No to beat. And definitely Home Off in this match. I gotta say, 6 minutes, that's a good sign. So to give you guys a little bit of context, for those who are just stopping in today, Fnatic routed the side of SodiPop. I definitely personally thought SodiPop would put up a little bit more of a fight, and SodiPop has been looking pretty good on the Tier 2 scene of NA. But you know what ended up happening? 3-0 route. Fnatic won the first map in 440, Fnatic won the second map in 451, and they won the King of the Hill 3-0. But 6 minute time, that only leaves 3 minutes total for the entire map to be able to played out if it would have continued on, which means it took about two-thirds of the time for TSM to go ahead and score against Oh No. It might just be a game where Oh No is going to be playing very well, and definitely agree with you. Their fanships are important, and I will try to get some envious games, guys, after this game. If this continues, and ESL is not going to be casting the continuation of this line of the bracket, it will be envious if they win their match playing the winner of this. So I ideally will stay with that, or I will be looking for Seagull, of course, to see what's going on with Energy, as they are definitely a team to be watching out for today. But for you guys are looking for envious. I'll see if I can go ahead and try to get some envious going on later on this stream. Again, thank you so much for stopping by, guys. This is the first game of the best of five. You can see that at the top of your screen, winner bracket round 8. As we're getting into it, there should be a stopwatch in the top left of your screen. I see it, 6 minutes remaining here for Oh No. And of course, if you guys have any thoughts or suggestions about the production of the stream, do let me know. We're going to go ahead and follow out Fact Fiction here until we get a bit dizzy from the no aim, no brain. But once he gets into his spot, They might be able to get a good jump here. That's going to be their goal. Genji and Winston going in at the same time. Genshin, I guess you could say. Chase Hill going to be able to take out Nicholas. This is the first kill of the fight. Both teams fighting it out in a little bit of a no grab, but JKW charging in. He's a bit alone. Zayd's going to be able to take him out. That's a quick kill. And now Harblue all alone on that famed Roadhog, but he goes down quickly. Zayd so far with the double kill, but Torque is able to answer, getting himself a kill, buying himself some time for his team. Shake able to help take out Mofit with Torque, and they're comboing together to get a lot done here. They're stalling it up. Dragonblade available for Torque. I don't know how he already farmed one up, but he's got it up. He's going to get himself a kill, taking out Zayd. Going to be continuing to look forward onto this. Lucio takes out Rockus, and now with the kill on Emoport. Oh no, may have had a great look at the beginning, but they didn't even get a tick. I don't know what to say there. That looked amazing from the Zayd and team. They had a great position. They had the kill feed going in their favor, but Torque getting out that Dragon Blade just so quickly helped his team a lot. No counter to that to be able to stop the damage from going out, and now they're going to be back on the point. We'll see Zayd and team. There is going to be a Deadeye from Mofit, but no kills. You saw it on the kill feed, as we are going to have the Winston in the background. There's going to be a Death Blossom, though. It does get canceled out, I believe, in a Transcendence coming out from Shake, as we do have the Self-Destruct from Mopor. He gets himself one kill, and that's going to be huge. Dragon Blade coming out from Chase, so this could be the deciding factor, as Fact Fiction has already checked out Joe Meister. Now there's going to be another kill. Mopork, Fact Fiction don't even need the Dragon Blade, although Chase Hill was responsible for those kills in the kill feed. Mofit, Fact Fiction, and the side of Zayd were able to get up most of those. So now we're going to be moving forward onto the second section with plenty of time for Ono to work with. 4 minutes and 18 seconds remain on the clock. No ultimates right now. I was just about to say, let's take a look at the ultimates, but none are remaining for any of the teams. The rest of the fighting will just be raw hero fighting, no ultimates, no gimmicks, no cues to win the game, as it will just be which team plays it out better fighting together. Defense going to be set up on top of General Store looking for the offense. Looks like they are going to be opting for a wraparound. No, defense just going to jump onto the payload here, as we do have TSM going in aggressively. There's going to be the Primal Rage coming out from the Winston. Torque has the Dragon Blade available whenever he chooses to use it, but JKW and Shake are all they need right now, as two kills for JKW, one for Shake. Torque going to be able to chime in, but definitely responsible for Shake and Torque as they are cleaning it up in the background. All of Ono basically getting cleaned up right there. They are going to have some respawns and some ability to fight, but they do have a lot of ultimates to work with. Both sides, actually. Nicholas, Shake, Harblue, Torque, all gonna have their ultimates. And now Joe Meister as well. If we look over to the side of Ono, Fact Fiction is gonna have his Primal Rage. We'll see what ends up happening. No kills from that, so that's good for the side of Ono, but they gotta get something working off the back of that. There's gonna be a hook. I believe that was from the offense, as Chase Hill is on that. And we are gonna have Fact Fiction going into the Primal Rage, trying to find it out. Mopork got himself a double kill with the Self-Destruct, but there was the Dragon Blade as well. It's going off in the middle with that Death Blossom from Nicholas, but it doesn't get any kill, and so far Ono is all of the kill feed. And if Torque goes down, that's gonna be a team kill going off to the side of Ono, as they are pushing forward in the Streets phase. We look at the time remaining, 2:45, and they might just be able to get the Streets phase with some time to work on the last point, guys. Ono's dream is not quite a meme yet, as they continue to push forward. There's Joe Meister's ultimate for the side of TSM, that sound barrier that could give them some opportunity to fight out. Well, we'll see if it ends up working for them. There's going to be the sound barrier. They're going to push forward. Mofit able to take out JKW to start the fight, but Harblue answers back. There's going to be the self-destruct from Harblue as he ends up getting Chase Hill after Mofit gets another kill, 2-for-2, and then Torque. He's going to start making it go that way. I say that Zayd, he gets traded out, though, in the end. So right now, it looks like the defense should be able to stabilize off the back of this, as Nicholas is still alive, getting those huge shots, able to get himself 3 kills on the fight. Takes out Moport, Rockus, and one other. And home up in the way it works is each round has its own starting map. The teams should be going to a different map for each round, but some of the rounds will have similar rounds from similar. So I believe the semifinals and the round of 16 are both Dorado, but that means all of the round of 8s are Hollywood. They do a different starting map for each round, except for some of the rounds eventually start to repeat. There's going to be a Deadeye coming out from the side of Mofit. We'll see if it gets any kills. They need it to. Time is starting to run thin on them. 138 as JKW is able to get that kill. We do have Torque channeling a Dragon Blade as well. And you know what? That's the sound of Cut Sushi and a dead side of Ono. If he can get the slices he needs to, and so far he's gonna be able to take out Chase, as it did look like we had Shake take out another kill, as Shake does end up going down to Fact Fiction, though Nicholas able to take it out, and there's the kill feed going to the side of the defense, and TSM fighting very strong right now, as they were on the precipice of being pushed onto the third point of this map, but I don't think it's going to be possible anymore. Only 1 minute and 10 seconds remain for Ono, as the energy is definitely for them in the chat, and I definitely feel their energy in the play, but at the same time, TSM is a strong team to play against right now. Zayd with the Transcendence. What will he be able to do? There's a Death Blossom coming out from Nicholas. This might just be the nail in the coffin. There was a Suicide coming out from Mopork. It is going to get two kills, but the clock, it's ticking every moment. Closer to midnight, not high noon, as we are going to have Fact Fiction taking out. Oh, no, never mind. Maybe they end up getting a lot of kills here. Fact Fiction, Mopork, every single kill going to the favor of them, except for Chase Hill, who ended up being taken out by Nicholas. They only have 30 seconds remaining, guys. And honestly, after the gates open, which takes about 10 seconds, unfortunately, it is going to be time on the clock. I won't be calling it until there is zero time remaining for Oh No. But what a performance on this first map. TSM looking, of course, the way they should. Dominant, somewhat mortal, as they haven't been an undomitable force in the meta, but they have been a very strong force in the meta. There's going to be a Dragon Blade coming out from Torque. This is definitely Fact Fiction. He just, no! Oh, the Earth Shatter! It's on four people! Fact Fiction, they don't want to give up. They are not going quietly into the night of Oh No, as it is going to be a 2-on-4 here to end it up. JKW ends up taking out Fact Fiction, and with Zayd, and basically Mopork is the only players left remaining that is going to be it, and time left is none, and GG's, yeah. And BTL. So we'll be having Oh No's choice and be awarding a point to TSM. What a match to start this series, guys. And really appreciate that. Ninja. I do really enjoy commentating Overwatch. That's part of the secret. The other secret is I used to talk a lot for debate in college and high school. But I love talking about Overwatch. So as long as there's Overwatch, hopefully the breath never ends. And looks like we will be giving MoFit, of course, a second to go ahead and get into Discord. But what a match, guys. What a match we are going to be in going into Game 2. And, of course, if you guys have any questions, thoughts, meta discussions, anything of that nature during these breaks, I would always gladly be willing to answer any questions and help out, as I do try to do my own series. Of course, Home Muffin's been talking about it, StratWatch. I do try to analyze the game and try to be at least decently educated about it. So if you guys have any thoughts, questions, ideas, etc., I can go ahead and do my best to answer them and give you guys some feedback. And as you guys have probably noticed, I am trying to pay attention to the chat during the cast and respond to stuff that is important, but at the same time, I will try to balance that out, of course, with the fact that I am going to be commentating the game and breaking down the game. But yeah, once MoFit's back into the Discord and he's good to go, guys, we're back into the match, and I gotta say, I did not expect this to be that close. Now, Northern Gaming Red lost to Oh No. Oh No should be able to take TSM to five games, I think. So we'll see. We will see. I might need more coffee today, guys. This is not going to end anytime soon today. And it looks like they're going to choose Hanamura. Are you kidding me? Woo! Okay, you know what? I'm willing to bet right now. I'm just going to throw myself out there that they took both of the two CPs off of Northern Gaming Red, which means that they have the two CPs as kind of like their silver bullet, if you want to look at it that way. Oh, man. Oh, no. This might be their dream day. And I don't know what to say. This is just going to be a great day, guys. And I'm going to go ahead and switch over to this screen, as we should be getting into it in just a moment, as it looks like Oh No will be staying on the blue side. And again, guys, thank you so much for stopping by into this channel. You guys are watching the ESL Atlantic Showdown NA qualifier, the regional qualifiers. The top 16 teams are currently competing it out in a series of best of fives. The top four teams of each region will go on to play in the LAN. And if you guys definitely go out there and on social media, on your friends list, tell your friends and fam about this stream. Tell your friends and fam about ESL underscore Overwatch. There's plenty of action. This is only the second game of today's stream here on my stream. So I will definitely be bringing you guys a lot more Overwatch action to come. So definitely be sharing the streams and letting people know about it. But here we go. Oh No. They're going to be out. And Chase. Well, guys, May is Bay or Amazing. Make America great again, right? Is that all the puns that we can get out? Yeah. Thank you, Chase Hill. Thank you. As he's going to be playing that May here. So a little bit of a different shakeup. So this is, again, guys, I got to say that I'm willing to put it out there. I'm willing to place the bet that it is a situation where Oh No might be willing to take it to two CPs as a strategical advantage to them based upon the fact that they were able to take out Northern Gaming Red. That is an assumption. I don't know. But they had to win three maps, right? And I gotta say, Northern Gaming Red has looked pretty good on payloads lately. And King of the Hills, I would never honestly peg them as a weak King of the Hill team. So Yeah, two CPs, probably part of it. Time bank is going to be the formula for this game, guys. We will be using the tiebreaker of Lijiang Tower if this goes to a tie. So here we go. We're on Hanamura. We're into the games. Let's get straight into it. We're going to go ahead and start with... We have two assassins, actually. We're going to start with Nicholas, as he's one of them. They're going to be going with a very high mobility offense here. Winston, D.Va, Genji, Tracer pushing in. Mopork able to take out JKW as they push through, but JKW was able to get the kill on the Mofit so far. 2-for-2 trade, as Nicholas is still alive, but Fact Fiction standing as a stalwart. Defense for his team until Nicholas ends up gunning him down, and now it's basically just left to this Mei Chase trying to survive as long as possible. The two supports on the point, all alone fighting it up against Nicholas, and this is no position you want to be in as a support. And Joe Meister able to take out Zayd, and that's just going to make it even easier, as the Lucio without the Zenyatta does not have the damage threat to be able to take out heroes, and he's going to be killed very quickly. Chase Hill will be able to deny the cap just for a second with this Mei, but it is... He will end up going down, and what a cheeky play. They did take a second to go ahead and react to that, but nonetheless, 1 minute push coming out from the side of TSM. They're going to be looking for the double cap. Let's see how it goes for them. Pulse Bomb available for Nicholas, as there's no ultimates available for the defense right now. Fact or Fiction will have access to that Earth Shatter in a second, as Torque will equally have access to a Dragon Blade as he just gets that up right now. We're going to go ahead and stay on him, as, of course, Pulse Bomb can make a high impact, but Dragon Blade, when you don't have a Graviton Surge, has a higher risk of getting a big impact for a team wipe here, as it looks like the Genji is going to go ahead and bust it out right now. Torque now looking for these slices. It's going to get Flashbang, taking a fair bit of damage, forced to use the Deflect, as a 2-for-2 trade has already ensued, and JKW Nicholas able to get the kills, but Fact Fiction on the end of it is able to answer so far. Shake, 3-for-3 trade, and this is just going straight into a skirmish, and there was no effect coming out of that Dragon Blade, but it doesn't end up mattering, as Shake gets himself a double kill at the end of it, along with a little bit of help from Torque, as now Nicholas gets himself a double kill onto Fact and Zayd, and Nicholas, Torque, Shake, as a trio might be able to just go ahead and win this match right now. We do see Fact Fiction the fastest one to be able to get there. I say that, the Lucio's already made it there. He's going to be on the point trying to stall it up. Chase goes down, as it is just going to be Tracer, Lucio, D.Va trying to stall it up as long as possible. Every second matters in Time Bank, as we are going to have the self-destruct going out. If he pops out of the map before the explosion, perfect timing, as the invulnerability will keep him alive. There is going to be a Deadeye coming out from Mofit. No kills gotten from that, and it's just a matter of seconds here as the Winston is able to effectively zone. More poke was able to pork, was able to get the Ice Block onto the point and buy themselves some additional time. There's another Transcendence and Dragon Blade going out, and TSM is not going to give up this easily. Neither is Ono, but it looks like that's going to be all the heroes. And finally, a take with 6 minutes and 30 seconds remaining on the time bank for TSM to work for the next offense as they switch over to the defense. And Ono looks to try to figure out their offense and work in a faster time. 2 minutes and 30 seconds was the total time needed to take both points. Definitely off the back of a double cap, but still, Ono looked pretty good if they can get their own offense going. Really, this is going to come down to the way 2CPs work, is I really feel like it mattered. Parity from the beginning matters so much for it to be even. If the side of Ono is only, like, let's say it takes them 4 minutes to win the next two pushes, right? Yeah, they would still have a total of 3 attempts, but if you take the 2 minutes and 30 seconds that that TSM took, and you average that out over multiple of the games, or multiple of the offenses, they're going to have 4 attempts to go ahead and take it. So it is important that Ono continues to parity, if not outright win, their overall offense time. As we take a nice look at the cityscape in the background, guys. High-speed trains going around. And again, thank you so much, guys, for tuning in to this. This is the ESL Atlantic Showdown NA Regionals Day 1 here on Twitch TV Dota Raptors. There's going to be more action today on this. This is only the round of 8, guys. There is the semifinals after this, as well as the loser's bracket. I'll be casting until I drop today, as I probably won't have any opportunity to cover matches tomorrow that isn't already covered by ESL Main. And hopefully just be enjoying it as a spectator like you guys. And of course, guys, do let chat know who you think's going to win. If you guys have anything that you want to be brought out or looked at, do let me know. But we will find out. We'll find out, Ninja. I definitely think that that was a very, very effective offense from TSM, but it can be offensively favored. So we'll see if the side of Ono is able to execute a 2-minute and 30-second take of both points. Here we go. Chase Hill, we're going to go ahead and follow him out. Looks like a pretty standard composition, although different completely in a lot of respects from the side of TSM. Looking for that slow push package. They got the Reinhardt barrier protectors. They have the Zarya. They have the Reaper. Chase Hill won't be having that Winston to jump in with him, so he will have to be very careful about how he goes about this. There is going to be the shots onto the turret. Looks like Harblue's already going to go ahead and build that up. As Harblue didn't even minish this. We have the Aardvark. Let's see if it pays off. Aardvark, aardvark. Looking for those left clicks. Not going to be able to get the shots there. Tagging up a little bit on the Mopork, but not too much more. As we do have the Reinhardt barrier, going to be able to protect it. Switching over to Nicholas as he was able to just go off right now. He's already on Zayd, able to force him down on the low ground. Zayd going to be able to pick up the health back. No, Nicholas says, haha, it's mine. And able to take out Zayd. Now going to be in the background looking on Fact Fiction. Maybe able to take him out as well. But the armor doing a lot to keep his HP from staying going down low. As it looks like there's going to be the sound barrier out from the offense. They're pushing in. Rockus able to get the only kill so far, but the defense holding strong. Mofit, though, able to make an answer in the background as he does get a kill. Zayd, oh, will they be able to hold on? Rockus is one of the only players left. I believe Mopork was on the way back, and that's horribly using the Molten Core, maybe a little bit aggressively and a little bit needlessly, as they were able to hold on to that regardless. But there we go. And yes, the entire tourney is going to be a best of five, guys. So there is a lot of action to go on today. And thank you for stopping by, Tifa, as we are going to have more action. Harblue, plenty of scrap in the back pocket. Two armor packs, 150 HP. Zayd, though, able to take out JKW. We're going to be switching over to him as he's been getting plenty of kills. Him and, honestly, Shake, for that matter, have been doing a lot. As there's going to be a Mofit kill on to Nicholas TJO. That's what they need. There's going to be the Transcendence from the side of the defense. What can they get done with this? As it looks like it's mostly going to be wasted. I say that Torque is going to be able to get the Dragon Blade off because of it. Now his Flashbang does have the Sound Barrier. Mofit gets cut in half. Cut to size, as there's going to be a Transcendence coming out from the side of the offense. Zayd keeping his team alive on the point, but they haven't even got a tick yet, guys. As you guys are saying, this is looking like a strong match from TSM so far on this point, and it looks like to be the case, even though there's going to be an Earthshatter coming out from JKW. Nicholas still alive, fighting it out. Zayd, what can you do for your team? You need to land some shots, but no. Cleaned up, dead, and there's going to be TSM holding on to the point. And yeah, they did end up nerfing the animation cancel. I found that out recently. Apparently, it does still slightly work, I think, by like 0.1 second per cancel. But like at the end of the day, it's almost worth it not to animation cancel anymore. Oh no, this was probably one of the maps that you ended up taking against Northern Gaming Red. I will have to ask afterwards to see how they ended up taking on Northern Gaming Red. But right now, can they do it? They do have their team behind. Mopork fighting it out. Mofit, Rockus both getting kills. One being the turret now. Two heroes down. Can they take out this Reinhardt? They will. JKW is dead. There's no resurrection on the table. And Nicholas is going to be the only hero left. And this is a much, much more effective push coming out of... Oh no, as you guys heard, that's the team kill horn. As Ono looks to continue to push forward, they're continuing to not look completely lost in this series. But nonetheless, TSM looking strong. 5:52 on the clock, and again, if they can get an immediate double cap, this is exactly what they need in this situation. They cannot afford to fall behind. As there is going to be an Earthshatter going out that is hitting on one, or the barrier was there to prevent it. Looks like they will charge away. Actually, that's pretty good, as the charge away is the Transcendence away from the fight. Can they capitalize on it? That's the big question. Fact Fiction going to be able to get their Fire Strike onto the turret, but not much more than that, as they're going to be able to spam it down. Chase Hill does have the Dragon Blade available, so if they could get something done with that, that would be the ideal scenario. Rockus ends up taking out the turret as Nicholas was able to take out Zayd. That's not a good start. There's going to be the Dragon Blade going out. We're going to need to switch back over to Chase as he's going to be looking for the slashes. Mopork able to take out JKW. Double slash on to Genji. Will be able to take out Torque. Torque goes down, but there was a Molten Core activated by Harblue. Let's see if he's able to get anything done with it. Does have a level 3 turret. Chase Hill gets two kills, but right now Harblue, he could be the nail in the coffin. He could be the stability that the defense needs. It's his turret. It's going to be hard to deal with. The Mopork taking a lot of damage will fall, and TSM able to stabilize and hold strong here after the double cap risk. Plenty of armor in the back pocket of Harblue, as well as Mofit's in a bad position. He's going to have to back off. Will he go down? And yes, guys, it is a best of five. As you can see at the top of your screen, winner's bracket round 8 should be a bar bracket, and then it'll say game 2 of 5. TSM. Let's see what the side of Ono's got here. Is they do have Mofit with the Deadeye. They have Zayd with the Transcendence. Fact Fiction getting close to the Earthshatter, but that's not enough, as there is going to be parity coming up from the side of the defense with the Dragon Blade, Earthshatter, and Sound Barrier. Nicholas Dow does get up his Pulse Bomb as well, and oh man, he's in a position. He's in a position. Pulse Bomb sticks. Fact Fiction, he survives. Good deal. That's necessary for Oh No fans. If they ended up losing Fact Fiction there, it'd be a bad situation. 4 minutes on Time Bank remains to 6 minutes. As Oh No needs to get something going, it looks like they are going to go for the low ground to try to flesh out Nicholas. Nicholas is going to get wind of it, just going to go ahead and back off, playing it smart. But there's going to be the Deadeye coming out. But he gets... Oh, he gets Earth Shatter. JKW able to get a good Earth Shatter as I end up switching over to Chase Hill. He gets charged by JKW, but JKW ends up going down. Sound Barrier absorbing a lot of the damage. It looks like so far the kill feed going in nothing but the favor of... Oh, no. As Harblue does activate that... the Molten Core. But the turret still alive. Able to keep getting damage. There's going to be the Graviton Surge for the side of the offense. Can they get anything done with it so far? No. As they are on the fight. We're going to go ahead and go to the overview. As they are on the point first tick taken. And it looks like there's going to be a lot of damage on Torque. He's getting low. Rockets able to take out Harblue. And they need this. Torque gets hooked. No, just as Mech. And will Torque be able to stay alive long enough? He's stalling it up. Only one tick has been taken. He is forced off the point. JKW. Now Shake. Now Joe Meister. Now Nicholas is all of the defenses to be able to get back on the point and force the side of Oh No off. And that is a major Oh No for them as they were only able to secure one tick off that fight. They can consolidate and be happy that they took that one tick, guys, but it is still only one tick. And if you look at the top of the clock, it is officially a time bank scenario because they took the first point. They will be awarded no more time throughout the rest of the series, except if they cap with less than 2 minutes remaining for their quote-unquote final attempt. Fire Strikes hitting both Reinhardts as they end up hitting each other. We have Torque actually switching over to Widow. Haven't seen him play this in a while. Of course, Widowmaker can just outright change the scope of a game, the battlefield of a game. As, of course, Hex likes to say, even before firing a shot, having a Widowmaker on the field changes the way the enemy team has to play. As there's going to be an Earth Shatter going out onto Chase. He ends up beating that. Torque looking for the shots. There's also the turret in the background. Him and Harblue in a good position as they are going to have the Transcendence going out from Zayd. Will it end up giving them enough of an opportunity to win this fight? They have gotten three kills. There's going to be a Deadeye going out from the McCree. Doesn't get any kills. Torque looking for the flick. Ends up missing. And right now they're on the point. They're able to fight it out. Contested is by one hero. And right now, Oh No might be able to take the point. Fact Fiction knocking the head off of Harblue as he's going to charge forward onto the two tanks. Able to get another kill onto JKW. They need to knock the D.Va out of her mech. And it looks like that it's going to be the Torque. Actually, Shay is in the mech and they will be able to take the point, guys. 1:54 seconds remains, which means it is going to be a 2 minute final attempt here for the side of Oh No. And you know what, guys? I think you're right. TSM is making this look a little bit easy, and unfortunately, that is not good for the fans of Oh No, and I know there's plenty of you in here. I am personally a bit of a fan of Oh No, as I have played with Fact Fiction before in Dota and against him in the competitive scene, and I'm definitely rooting for him, but TSM, they're the team to beat on paper, and man, they are looking terrifying to play against right now. Even with the pocket strategy coming out from the side of Oh No with their Mei, of course, it is something that Envious will do quite a bit, Tailspin being the player that does do that, but nope. Didn't look that good at all compared to when you expect to see what Tailspin is able to do with that Mei. So, defense looking a bit different here as we do have a... not going to have that as Mei coming out. We are going to be going very standard here. Reaper, McCree. Same offense, though, from the side of TSM. Not really surprised at all, though. This works out really well. The internal synergy between Zarya and Winston is just... It's so many levels, right? Level 1, bubble on a jumping Winston. Gives him extra 200 HP, prevents stuns from the Winston, and allows Winston to guaranteed get the bubble down to kite. Synergy level 2, Graviton Surge plus Tesla Cannon is an absolutely devastating combo of damage. Synergy level number 3, if you can get people in a Graviton Surge, you can bubble them and protect the people that are in fighting the Graviton Surge. So you can protect where a Winston will bubble themselves to protect them from the Graviton Surge they're hit by. The offensive Winston can insulate the Graviton Surge and prevent people from being able to assist it. So lots of internal synergies between Winston and Zarya. Very cool. Yeah, first time Widow. Kekekek. Never played Widow. Couldn't hit his shots. Obviously, guys, he's a bad player. As we are going to have JKW jumping in here, able to get some good cleave. You see the Winston, no aim, no brain, able to get 3-4 targets as he's looking around. So far, kill feed, though, going for the defense as Oh No is able to get themselves a pair. As Zayd and Fiction take out 2, Mopork now able to answer as well. He's on low HP, but he ends up taking out Shake. 100% charge. This is what you want to see from your Zarya. Lots of damage, lots of ultimate building, and of course, just a huge threat. We'll see what ends up happening into this next push here. TSM thwarted on their first attempt. Second attempt, Oh No, of course, looking to thwart as well. Zarya with his decent charge could be a threat to them. Zayd already does have that Transcendence up, and there's already a huge charge coming out. That's the big disadvantage to running a Winston against a Zarya, as you just basically charge the Zarya. Fact Fiction. Oh, I missed that on stream. He ends up hitting a 4-man Earth Shatter, cleaned up with his team, and that's going to be the next push. And right now, Oh No might be giving themselves an opportunity, guys. PogChamps in chat, energy. Let us know who you think's going to win, of course, and let us know who you think you want to win. As I know there's fans of Oh No, Mark, definitely a big fan of them, whereas TSM fans, a little quiet, as they are very happy with the game, the way it's going right now. We're going to go ahead and switch over to Nicholas for now. He's been doing work on that Tracer with a Pulse Bomb available. They'll be looking for the Graviton Surge. Oh, it ends up going down. There's a good Graviton Surge Pulse Bomb, but it is canceled out. That is a lot of stuff going on. Double Transcendence, double Graviton Surge, but it looks like the offense is able to get the better deal of it. Oh man, it's a team kill, as the only person left alive was Rawkus, and he was the first person to go down in the fight, and that means TSM is able to take the point, only needing about a minute, 2 minutes total, to be able to take that first point and get on into their time bag. At this rate, they will be guaranteeing themselves a third attempt on their offense, and that's exactly what they need to be looking for. However, the side of Oh No definitely looking for a better look here, and a better defense, and ideally stall them out pretty big. Let's see what ends up happening though, MoFit, with that Pulse Bomb. Mirroring a little bit of the south there. There's going to be a Death Blossom coming out of Chase. He gets one kill onto Shake. Ends up helping up Zayd clean up Harblue, and that's another kill, but they're on the point. They need to get there before they cap a put tick, and it looks like that is going to be the pace. There will be a rewind coming out from Tracer, but a quick smack from Fact Fiction is going to be able to clean that up, and thank you everyone for stopping by. If you guys haven't, definitely get out on social media. This is the second day of today, guys. Game of today. Second series of today, we're in the second game of it. It is currently 1-0 to TSM, but there's more action here on the stream, / Dota Raptors, as well as / ESL _ Overwatch. Guys, this is the last 2 days of the regionals for the Atlantic Showdown. MoFit trying to deal with Nicholas in the background, and Torque. It looks like Torque will be taken out by him. Good tracking there by MoFit and Fact Fiction. We need to switch over to him as he's doing work. Gets himself a double kill onto Joe Meister and Shake. Meanwhile, Zayd is able to take out JKW, and that's going to be all of TSM's next attempted offense completely cleaned up. And Oh No, have you stabilized? Have you made it so that you might be able to have an opportunity to win this map? They have to have a good defense here. If they don't, they will be too far behind in the time bank. It matters so much. I cannot emphasize the amount of importance on this defense, of course, because they are on their final attempt. Push forward coming out from MoFit as he has that Pulse Bomb looking for the shots, able to deal up quite a bit of damage to both Torque and to Nicholas, but it's not going to be enough. There's a Graviton Surge. Can they get the big Pulse Bomb? It doesn't even matter. As Fact Fiction and Chase Hill get themselves enough kills, and Shake is going to be one of the only members left alive as Nicholas. Well, he just respawned. So did Torque. And they're going to be looking for another look. So, now they're down to the final attempt, basically. Even if they kept the point, I'm pretty sure the TSM would take more than 15 seconds to do it. So both teams are going to be down to their final attempts on their next offenses. The question remains in our heads, or in the heads of the viewer, and then the heads of Oh No, is whether or not TSM, or whether Oh No will be able to hold TSM to the overtime and no time remaining. Graviton Surge is available here for the offense, I believe. Yes, Harblue. Now there's going to be a Dragon Blade attempted to come out from Torque, but a great hook from MoFit. Chase Hill, ends up negating that. There's going to be the Graviton Surge and the Pulse Bomb and the Dragon Blade and the Transcendence and the team kill, as it looks like the side of TSM is not messing around anymore. They build up 6 ultimates. They use up 5 ultimates. They use up all of them, and they end up cleaning up that fight as JKW was the only one not to ultimate in that fight. But now, TSM 4-2 here on the side of Hanamura, up 1-0 on the series. This is turning out to be quite the match, guys. As I definitely agree with you, this is definitely looking like a TSM favored series, but I don't think it's going to be an instant win here for them. Oh No is definitely giving them some runs for their money. Some of the fights are definitely going in the favor of Oh No. The question becomes is whether or not Oh No can step up. I think it's been clearly established here that TSM is the stronger team, that they are the better team. And of course, most of you who have watched the competitive scene for a long time now, that's a little bit of a no-duh statement. But what I want to emphasize here is that Oh No has been up and coming, and that before this, I would have been willing to say that TSM should rout Oh No, and it would be a very not I can't think of the word, my mind's going blank right now, but it would not be a very close series. Oh No is proving that they do have the ability to take it to the best and to be able to win fights and to be able to outfrag them and outslay them and out team play them. The question is, can they consistently get that together? We'll find out here. It's of course the new patch is that the starting times for 2CPs have been shortened for both offense and defense, only 45 seconds now at the beginning of the match. Much more convenient for both teams to go ahead and get into it. And here we go, guys. We're going to be getting right into the action as we have MoFit going to be on the McCree, and they need to go ahead and get a good offense going here. Already 8 seconds on the clock. Again, this is their final attempt. We're going to go ahead and stay on him. Actually, we should probably go out on Chase, as he's going to be the primary aggressor here. He's going to be the one looking for the space, as there is going to be a lot of damage onto him. He looks like he isn't able to deal with that turret again. Harblue going to be running that Torbjorn, and he's already dealing a lot of damage. It looks like Rockus ends up going down to Joe Meitzer, and Chase Hill falls to JKW. If there's another kill here, this is definitely going to be the first offense, and yes, team kill. Zayd, you're dead inevitably, friend. I'm sorry, as he's going to get killed as well, and that's going to be a lot of scrap. And the one thing about Torbjorn, unfortunately, I am quite a bit of a Torbjorn player, but the one big thing about Torbjorn is that when you win fights, especially if it's a trade, if Torbjorn's the last member to live on your team and the defense all gets in position, you get double the scrap, because you get scrap from your turret death, your teammate's death, and enemy threat. So the amount of HP, looks like you can see it right now. Shake, JKW, Nicholas, and Harblue going to be sitting very happy with another 300 HP total across them. Nicholas able to take on Mofit for the first fight, and that's not what you need to be seeing at all right now. And Torque, he does end up going down to Mopork, but I don't know if it's going to be enough, as we do have Nicholas in the background still fighting out against Matt Fact Fiction, delaying that initiation and buying his team space to make better fights, as there aren't going to be as many heroes for him to contend with at once. There's going to be a Graviton Surge. It ends up catching on a few, but it looks like Nicholas is able to break out of it and able to take out Zayd. JKW onto Rockus after he takes out Harblue, but it's not going to be enough for Oh No, as they're going to end up losing this push here, and the side of TSM is able to stabilize and maintain their defense. And yes, sir, we are on Hanamura. It was the choice of Oh No, as they lost the first match. Loser's choice on the next map on every single one of these games for today, and they chose Hanamura in the improved map pool. Mofit able to get taken out here by Shake. 10 seconds remain from Oh No, as it might just not even need to go to coin flip, aka tiebreaker here, and they're gonna already call GG's, as they lost too many members. And that is going to be the next map, and it is going to be going over to the side of TSM. No surprise there as far as on paper goes, but Oh No is not making this look easy for TSM. I definitely think TSM is the better team, guys, but I still think it's worth highlighting that Oh No is not a weak looking team right now, not the kind of team with a no name in relation to a lot of the other teams in these brackets. But as it stands, TSM looking to go up 2-0, as they did. Now if they only win one more map, it will be match point, and it is currently, sorry, match point for them. And if they win, well they go on to play most likely Envious, as I'll go ahead and update the bracket right now for some downtime. But as it stands, it is a TSM show. Envious has already routed out Method. That was a really quick match, guys. So it will be the winner of this going on to play Envious. Assuming that ESL doesn't go on to cast that match next, I will continue on this line of the bracket for you guys, because I know there's a few of you in here that do want to watch Envious. But what a series so far, guys. Oh No, not looking like a complete underdog. They definitely have been putting up some team fights and fights. But TSM up 2-0, only needing one more map. What will be the choice of Oh No? Well, I don't know what to say, really. I'm kind of like, I really expected Oh No to look a little bit, they took out Northern Gaming Red to get here, guys. Like, it isn't like it is a fluke. I mean, Northern Gaming Red, yes, they had Red. Yes, they had the recent drop of Bird. Yes, there is that drama. Yes, you could look at all that, but that doesn't mean that the team overall is, like, nearly as weak in some respects. Bird is a strong player, do not get me wrong, and I don't want to dive too much into the drama here, because this isn't a Drama Llama stream, but I do want to focus on the fact that Northern Gaming Red was a good team. They took out Cloud9 in the OG Invitational. That was decently recent. Definitely something we can still look at as a match result. But yet, here, they end up losing to Oh No. So Oh No, maybe moving it up, maybe solidifying themselves as a top tier 2 team, maybe even looking to make it into the tier 1 of the NA scene, but that's going to be decided here. Yep, there are two capture points. Temple of Anubis is also in this map pool, guys. So the map pool is Kings Row, Temple of Anubis, Hanamura, Dorado, Hollywood, Kings Row, and then the decider is Lijiang Tower. I can go ahead and link that, though. I'll go ahead and pull up the rules real quick in another tab and go ahead and give you guys that quick copy paste arena. And Lijiang Town is the decider. I will find the tiebreaker rules, and if they haven't been linked, cool. All right, you guys got it covered in chat. Awesome, thank you. So I will leave you guys to your thing, but so it is definitely an important match today, or this match specifically, because who won the first map? The first map was TSM. You guys, I don't have it up on my screen. It is what was the first map? It was Hollywood. Yep, it was Hollywood, and it was honestly a little bit closer than I expected. Ono ended up getting to the last section of the map with like 10 seconds remaining on their stopwatch. So Ilios is going to be the choice. So they're just going to be taking it to non-objective-based maps. So they think their fragging power and their teamfighting power is the same. And, you know, honestly, at the end of the day, I think that Hex put this right. When you lose on an objective-based map, one of the best logics to follow is that if you remove factors to lose, you might have lost because of team communication, you might have lost because of strategy, because of composition, other factors that asymmetric maps are more prone to have, whereas a symmetrical King of the Hill fragging match is going to be based upon your individual skill, team shotting, and all that other stuff. So it is very important to switch it up there. Okay, there's still an audio desync. I'm really sorry about the audio desync, guys. I had this happen yesterday, and I got it fixed up for my testing, but I don't know. Rip the dream. That's all I have to say there. And it looks like both teams are potentially ready. As Rockus has said, ready. I imagine TSM is basically good to go. But yeah, guys, unfortunately, I apologize for the desync. I don't know what's causing that. I've tried everything I can to mess with it, but I don't know what's causing the audio desync. I wish I knew. I really did. If you guys are better at streaming in the sense that you guys know more about streams, more about this kind of stuff, it would be really helpful for me to know for some extra troubleshooting stuff. Of course, I've tried restarting the computer, restarting the stream, but I did test it earlier, and I had the same problem on a previous cast for Sunday for the Go 4 Cup. So, we'll see. And it was Hollywood, Caterese. It was Hollywood. Second map was Hanamura. So we've gone from Hollywood to Hanamura in this series so far. Well, oh no. What can you bring us as I need to update the top again, guys? Do let me know if I forget to update this, as it is important as well. It is going to be game 3 of 5. Yeah, Hollywood is definitely a strong map for them, I think, as well. Specifically because back in the day, I mean, if you think about it too, just logistically wise, Torque was one of the best Widowmakers of the Widowmaker era. Of course, Grego is another one that you have to bring up in that respect. But definitely Reaver is a big one. Even Mindo had his moments where he was playing an absolutely amazing Widow. But of course, Gods. He had that quad kill at the OG Invitational that was just mind-boggling for LG at the time. They were, but now Energy Gaming. But what I want to emphasize is that is a playground for Widowmakers. So it makes a lot of sense that TSM has practiced and played that map quite a bit, because it was a playground for one of their best players, best heroes at the given patch during that time. Of course, we will go ahead and refresh the brackets real quick to see what's going on. Most likely we'll be following Envious along, and yeah, I am ready. And be checking on the caster chat to see where they are going next, and they are into game 2. Fnatic versus Energy. So if you guys want to go watch Fnatic versus Energy and pull up a multi-stream, you can go ahead and do that there. Twitch.tv/ESL_Overwatch is where you guys can find the other cast that's going on. That is the main cast, the B cast here. Twitch.tv/DotaRaptors is where you guys are right now. Definitely follow the channel if you guys haven't, and spread the word about this, as there's only so much marketing I can do while I'm doing the casting for these teams. But of course, these teams deserve plenty more viewership than what they currently have, as this game could be the end for Oh No. Match point for TSM as they walk in here on to Ilios. And we'll see what they end up going with here. It looks like a pretty standard strategy. We're halfway through the series, so we'll go through another set of introductions for you guys. Harblu going to be picking up a Winston here for them. Pretty standard, as we have JKW with that synergistic Zarya. Nicholas going to be picking up the Tracer, as he's been playing it very well together today. Shake going to be over here on his Zenyatta. We have Torque going to be on his Reaper. And last but not least is going to be good old Joe Meister picking up the Lucio. Over here for the side of the red team, for the side of Oh No, as I double check the titles, as I need to fix this real quick. We do have the side of Oh No going to be on the red team. They are down 0-2 against TSM, as they're going to be engaging over here onto the right side near that health pack in the pillar room, looking for the shots. Rock is able to help get the kill, maybe onto the Torque, as he's able to get away. But so far, 3 kills to the side of Oh No, as they look to be winning this off the back. of a good initiation from Rockets, I gotta say, as well as just basically the rest of Ono, but they will get control of the first point here, and this is exactly what Ono needs, if not for just simply the control of the map, if not for the confidence factor being down 0-2. Remember, guys, match point here for the side of TSM. If at any point Ono loses a map, they lose the series. Zade's gonna end up going down as Nicholas ends up helping take him out as Harblue was there well on MoFit. Looks like FactFiction Rockets able to answer in the background as Mopork's gonna end up going down to Nicholas TJO in a decent trade as it's a 3-for-3, but this Tracer just doing way too much damage. There's gonna be a droppy going up for the side of Chase as he's able to get a lot done there. Looks like the Rockets is able to help take out that Tracer, and again, so far, it looks like the side of Ono has gotten themselves a good control of this point. FactFiction does end up going down to Harblue as he's in that Primal Rage, zoning it out, getting his team space. He's going to end up taking out Rockets as he gets himself a double kill in that. We'll be pushing forward here. Does have to deal with the double support. Does have the barrier available in just a second, I imagine. But no, one dies 1 second as it was about to come back up. Nicholas with that pulse bomb could be making big plays for his team as there is two more kills. Pulse as Moffitt takes out Shake after the side of Harblue ends up going down. JKW onto Mopork, and that's a big trade, but there's a knockoff. JKW ends up falling off, and there's going to be a Deadeye coming out from MoFit. This could be huge, as there's going to be a Deadeye. Death Blossom as it ends up getting two kills. Rockets taking out Nicholas and Torque, so big kills for them. MoFit and team up 50% to 16. Actually, a decent chance for them in this game, as TSM is looking like to be on the back foot from the start. And there are definitely some teams that have come out and said 2CPs are actually their favorite maps to play right now is Tick Nicholas. Oh, that pulse bomb, triple kill on the Graviton Surge. Synergy, teamwork, gonna net them a win. One fight here, as it looks like it is gonna be Rockets going down. FactFiction is gonna be the only member left alive, as he is gonna have to go for the escape plan. If he doesn't get out here this way, he's gonna get out in a body bag or a casket and be sent back to the spawn after 10 seconds. But it looks like the side of TSM will have decent ultimate so far. We will have Parody and Zade and Chase Hill with both of the Transcendence and the Graviton Surge. However, Rockets doesn't have the that's what I was talking about. That Death Blossom from Torque doing a lot of damage. He gets himself a total of one kill, helping out Nicholas get another. Now going to push forward, able to take out. It looks like Chase Hill getting a lot of cleave damage, and Joe Meister able to take the credit for those kills. But no doubt there that was Torque doing a lot of the damage, and TSM seems to be gotten some firm control of this map back after the early control coming out from Ono. Death Blossoms are going to be available here in a little bit for Rockets, as well as more ultimates, as there is going to be the Mopork or Graviton Surge comboing those together. There is no Transcendence available for Shake, as he's quite a bit a ways away from it. So if they could find their opportunity before that Transcendence is used, there's going to be the beat drop coming out from the side of TSM. See what they can get done with it, as there is a push forward. There's going to be the Transcendence for the offense, as FactFiction gets the first kill. Rockets going to go ahead and use the Death Blossom. He gets himself out one, but two, and three. He's just going to go ahead and help take out Nicholas, as FactFiction cleans up Harblue, and that's going to be a team kill, as Oh No looks to take control of the first point of Ilios, tying it up basically 79% to 79 here in just a second. And this is definitely going to be a close match all the way to the end, guys. As again, Oh No, if they lose this map, it's all lights out for them. They're going to go into the loser's bracket, and the gauntlet of best of five continues, as they're going to have to play more matches to end up making it to the LAN. Winner of this will go on to play Envious, as MoFit ends up taking out Joe Meister. That's a big kill for them, buying them more time, 90% to 0, or 79% here, as we're going to have a pulse bomb going out. Nicholas gets himself a double kill, and that's going to help them out a lot, making it a triple as he ends up taking out MoFit. And the only two heroes left are going to be Rockets and Zade, and if they're not in a good position right now, which they aren't, they're going to get it in it cleaned up. And will it tick? No, not ticking quite night to 99%. And what a teleport from Rockets, bit of a fail fish there. He will end up going down to Shake, and now 85% to 98%. And I really wonder whether or not the side of Oh No is going to be able to get back here in time and be able to take this point. And it looked so set in stone for them to be able to. Nicholas going to do everything he can to slow it up 95% to 98, as this game is not going to get any closer. Or not going to get any further apart, as there is going to be the overtime engaging here now, as the fight's going to go out to Torque and Nicholas trading out, as we are going to have a Death Blossom coming out. Is it enough from Torque? No, he ends up going down as Rockets gets himself some big kills. There's only two heroes left. Harblue is going to be the only one left for the side of TSM, dropping down to 70 HP, and will go down as Rockets gets himself a triple kill on the Death Blossom, and they're going to be able to take the first point. That's going to be a cap, and that's going to be the first map of Ilios being awarded to Oh No in the darkest moment here, in the darkest hour for them. They need to win this map. Down 0-2 in the series versus TSM. If they do not win, they will be knocked down in the loser's bracket, and it only gets harder for them to be able to make it to the LAN. Some hope, some life alive here, as Oh No takes the first map on Ilios against TSM. TSM going to be a little bit lost for words, as they're not exactly sure what ended up happening there. I'm not sure what ended up happening there, as I take a quick drink of water. probably just great play from all the players in general from the side of Ono, but Death Lotham from Rockets getting himself a triple kill at the end, that's got to be a major contributing factor and something that will be brought up in the post-match analysis. But it's not over yet. 1 of 3. TSM is almost just as close as the side of Ono, as they are down 0-1 on this map, but up 2-0 on the series. Initiation from Mara Blue with that bubble going to be looking onto Rockus and Mopork, but not too much damage, as there is that Zarya bubble going to be preventing a lot of it, but there's the initiation on the background. Going to be looking for the shots onto Zayd, but does get discorded up. Will go ahead and allow him to cause him to back up, but it looks like he might be able to just take out Zayd here, and now he's able to get on Chase Hill, and this is how you play Winston, guys. No aim, no brain, but I'll tell you what, if you're in the right place at the right time, Winston will cleave everyone the same, as it looks like Mara Blue is going to end up going down. Rockus will be at low HP as he does go down, was able to take out Mara Blue, but Nicholas with the double kill, able to go ahead and solidify their team the point, and unlike Ono taking the first point last time and controlling it for the first 50%, it is going to be the side of TSM to take the first point here on the side of, well, of Ilios. 15% and ticking, pulse bomb available as well as with a Primal Rage. There is, however, the pulse bomb and parity from Mofit. Nicholas able to take out Zayd. That's a good start for them. Been getting a lot of that Harmony Orb as well as the Discord Orb synergy damage. Pushing forward, looking for the shots onto Mopork. Not going to be able to get a lot of them, but it looks like it will be able to take out Mopork. Yeah, no, Chase Hill ends up going down. Torque able to take out Fact Fiction. Now Mopork all alone on the point will end up falling. And this looks like to be TSM's great revenge, as they do not want to look mortal. As, of course, their next match is going to be going up against Envious. And, of course, winner of that will be going on into the next stage of the tournament, which, you know what, guys, remember, this is the regionals day one. Winner of this goes on to play the semifinals. Winner of that goes on to play in the $100,000 LAN at GamesCon. 5 ultimates available for the side of TSM, as we are only going to have 2 for the side of Odo. Primal Rage and Sound Barrier are available. Mopork, Zayd, Rockus all getting close to their ultimates, but not close enough to count it yet, as we are going to have to push forward. There's going to be a Graviton Surge hitting on quite a few of them. It looks like actually everyone, as there is also the Mara Blue going to be able to get that cleave through. There was a Death Blossom from Rockus, but it didn't end up doing much, as Zayd was basically the only member to survive that, as he's off to the right, just hiding away the best he can. But again, looks like TSM has secured themselves this map. It's just a matter of time for them to be able to go ahead and get the tick, as it goes 1-1. 15% to go here. Multiple ultimates available as they have a Transcendence Dragon Blade. There's going to be the Sound Barrier coming out from Joe Meister's, the parody Sound Barrier coming out from the side of Oh No, as Mara Blue ends up taking out Mofit. Torque onto Zayd, and with Shakes, Transcendence, I think this is just going to be it, as we do have Torque ending the Dragon Blade, able to get the one kill at the end of it, and it looks like Rockus does end up going down. Fact Fiction going to try to stall it up best he can, has no hope given up. $100,000 land is what they want to play in, but it looks like it is going to be a 1-1. And again, guys, TSM tied up now. It's just a best of 3 here on Ilios, and if TSM wins this, it is going to be GG 3-0 going to the side of TSM in the series. Again, guys, you can see that at the top of your screen. You guys should be able to see a winner bracket round of 8, game 3 of 5, and then the commands that you guys will be using throughout the day, exclamation point bracket, the VODs, and then, of course, the score of what the actual series is right now. I just don't know what to say right now. This is crazy. Oh No, looking like a much better team than the previous two games. They end up taking that first map. They end up looking a little bit better on well, but not good enough. The question is, did TSM step it up after they got a fire lit out from under them as they lost the map to Oh No? And can Oh No continue to step it up and play to the same degree that got them that first point in the first place? That's what we're going to find out here. Following out Mofit onto this McCree, see what he can get done here. As he's going to be looking for multiple targets. Look at that Tracer! What a great flick taking out Nicholas. That's the first blood of this match, as Mara Blue is going to answer taking out Rockus, but Fact Fiction with the third kill, as it's 2 so far for the side of Oh No and only 1 for the side of TSM. If they can continue this kind of trade out, Oh No might be able to take the second point here and go up map point and be able to buy themselves a little bit of time in this series, as of course they have to win 3 in a row to be able to actually win the series, and they are going to go ahead and get in control of the point first here. As again, guys, TSM is up match point, up 2-0 on the series, whereas here in Ilios it is 1-1. Best of 3 remaining to be played out. Looks like definitely Mopork was the big beneficiary of that fight, up to 65% ult already, and I gotta say, Fact Fiction is another one that's worth highlighting in that respect. He's already up to 70% on a D.Va. And yeah, they do jump off at the end for fun sometimes. But he might have got bopped off. I was too busy looking. I was too busy thinking about what's going on in the next stuff. As Nicholas is going to end up picking out Zane Mofort, trades it out onto Torque, as we are going to have a 1-for-1 trade. JKW onto another one, but there's going to be the Nerf Fist going out. Will it end up doing enough damage? It does! Fact Fiction takes a Harbloom Joemeister. Now it looks like it is just going to be JKW on the point with that Zarya. Going to be having to run out 60, 50 HP. Going to be using that bubble, but it's not enough. Fact Fiction ends up cleaning him up, and they're going to be in control at this point pretty thoroughly, even though they do end up losing it. And I say best of three because the King of the Hill is now 1-1, which means we are only playing a best of three on this map. There's only three possible games left remaining for Ilios. Shake does have the Transcendence available. Nicholas does have the Dragonblade available. Moport with the combo. Deadeye, Mofit. We'll see what ends up happening. There's going to be the Dragonblade going out. Let's see what they can end up getting done with that, as it is going to be Winston taking a lot from that beam, but Torque ends up taking out Mofit, and that's not what you want to be seeing right now. Mofit should be, Torque should be losing his blade soon as he does, and there's going to be the Graviton Surge coming out from Mopor, hitting on quite a few. Is it going to be enough, though? That's always the question we have to ask ourselves. So far, the point will be flipped over to the side of TSM, and Mopork's getting zoned back. Torque is still alive and getting a lot of work done, as it looks like Rockus was able to take out Joemeister, but Joemeister will end up going down as Mopork able to take out Nicholas after he takes out Chase Hill. 1-for-1 trades and an even clash back and forth. It's absolutely crazy. Absolutely crazy. But it looks like the side of Ono will be able to get back on the point and control it for now. I say that, Harblue says, no, I don't want you to be in control of it quite yet. There's going to be the Graviton Surge going out. How many did it hit on? It looks like it hit on 3, 4, 5. There's going to be the Pulse Bomb! And Nicholas with the 4, man! If he could continue this with his brother Torque, they're going to go ahead and clean it up. And that's a 2-4 as the team kill comes out. And what a Graviton Surge. I'm sorry for your ears, guys, but hot damn, for lack of a better way to explain it. Nicholas and Harblue coming together in a key moment as they want to go ahead and win this as quick as possible. Remember, guys, if they win this, which, of course, they do have to win one more map to go ahead and take it, they have to play Envious in the next match, so they got to look as clean as possible. And that was very clean coming out from Nicholas and squad, as it looks like there's going to be a Dragonblade coming out from Torque. He's going to be looking for those kills. Shake with the Death Dodge to the Self-Destruct, because there's going to be another slash from Torque. He ends up getting 3 kills on the Dragonblade. Now going to be looking over onto Fact Fiction. He tries to get out alive, but looks like the grave is the only way back for him, as he's going to end up backing off and falling away. As no, he doesn't end up dying, but he ends up wasting the time anyways, as he had to go back to his spawn. And now 1-1, TSM percents away from being able to secure this map, as Torque is going to be able to get into the flank, able to get a lot of damage onto Mofit, forcing out the rewind, and that's going to be awkward for Mofit, as he won't have that available for the next fight. Harblue super low, fighting it out in that Primal Rage, and it looks like Rockus was able to get in the flank with that Sights, but he's going to get zoned by Rockus, and now he's going to get healed up as well after the end of that Primal Rage, and now the Sound Barrier as well, keeping his team alive. Torque with a double kill, as he's gotten 4 on this fight. Joemeister to clean up another one, and Torque with a total of 5 kills at the end of that fight. Zayd the only one alive, but that's because he's back at spawn, and Oh No goes down 2-1 on Ilios. And at this rate, guys, at this rate, Oh No is going to look like to go down in the loser's bracket and have to fight their way up. Sorry, I just needed to respond to Caster Chat real quickly. Okay, just sorry, responding to that real quickly. Yeah, I apologize, guys. Excitement, I have to... It's just a good day, guys, I apologize. Excitement is something that I tend to get a little bit into when the action gets intense. As I am casting from my apartment in a room, it is harder to balance than a studio, but I will try to keep that in mind as Nicholas continues to push forward. Zayd able to take him out, though. That's a good kill for the side of Oh No. They need to get him under control if they are going to win this match. And I say that, Harblue able to take out Zayd, so another target that they need to be worrying about. This monkey is doing a lot for them as he does end up going down to Mopork, and it looks like the side of Fact Fiction and team Mopork and squad able to go ahead and get onto this point and fight continually and actually able to get something done here. They're going to go ahead and look over onto the side of Joemeister as he goes down. Looks like Torque wants to go ahead and fight it out. A little bit of a greedy play. So does Nicholas. And it looks like Torque will go down. Mofit did end up falling, but Shake ends up taking out the side of Fact Fiction while they did lose Nicholas. And so the side of TSM able to prevent the flip so far for right now. And this is critical to go ahead and buy them more opportunity to have less percents for the side of Oh No. But right now they are able to flip it. Oh No in control of the 0.5% and counting. Mopork getting knocked up around by this Winston, as it looks like he did jump across, able to survive for right now. As Harblue is out of that Primal Rage, there's going to be the Graviton Surge. It hits on 1, 2, 3, 4. Can they capitalize on it? But there is going to be the Dragon Blade coming out from Torque. And Torque, he's just going to town right now. 1, 2, count him, 3. As he's going to be looking for the 4th, but Zayd is nowhere to be found. As he's hiding. Where is he at? Way back here. Just respawning. And that's going to be a good Dragon Blade, Nicholas, with another Pulse Bomb available. And rip your guys' ears as he has one. As I'm sure there will be an awesome play in just a second. And definitely Nicholas to highlight here is he's been able to get on the supports. And I mean, that's what happens when you run double assassin. You have to be able to get on the supports. And I gotta say, honestly, right now, my highlight is Harblue, as he's been able to create so much space for Nicholas and Torque to be able to operate and do what they're doing. What you guys are seeing on your screen, we're not following him as much because it's harder to. But at the same time, Winston is doing a lot of work. There's going to be a Transcendence coming out as Chase Hill got his own Dragon Blade out, and he's trying to look at his own work. He's going to be able to get one kill onto JKW, make it a second as he takes out Harblue over the well, and Nicholas is going to be the only member alive as he's going to be over here on the spawn, grouping up with his team to fight it out. 25% to 43% as the side of Ono has gotten some control back in this match, and they are their backs against the wall. They are facing map point, match point against TSM here in the round of 8 of the EU NA regionals for the Atlantic Showdown. Graviton Surge going to be coming out for the side of Ono, or sorry, for the side of TSM. Pulse Bomb doesn't end up doing that much if there was the double barrier available. Harblue ends up getting himself a double kill onto Mopark. In fact, Fiction is JKW takes out Rockus, and with Chase Hill dropping as low as he is, he's going to fall into the pit, and he's going to end up going down, and that's going to be a very clean and clear cap for the side of TSM, as they're taking 44%, 50% for the side of Ono, and it's getting closer and closer to that coveted, well, GG moment for the side of TSM fans. As I will have an update for you guys as far as what you guys can see on your stream, so you know, as we are going to have Harblue taking out Zayd. There's going to be Rockus taking out Harblue. Torque onto Torque, double kill from him, make it 3 as he's continuing to take out Mofit, and Shake is able to take out Fact Fiction. And just when Ono had an opportunity with 2 kills off the back of it, Torque cuts down their hopes just as he cuts down their bodies, and getting 3 kills, puns galore, kills galore, and we are going to have the side of TSM most likely taking this map right now, as it's very close to their win. Nicholas does have the Pulse Bomb, which could be the nail in the coffin for the side of Ono. 10% remains. Can they get back onto it? Can they be able to get there? Pulse Bomb's going to go out. It's stuck! Oh, no. Okay, it didn't end up getting the kills, but it did a lot of damage there. It's going to be the rewind. Zayd going to be taking a lot of damage from this, and if he doesn't get the Transcendence off, 3% away from it, that might be a critical factor here, as Chase is going to go ahead and pull out the blade. But that Pulse Bomb, it did so much damage to all of them when they went in, and they're so hurt. They're fighting it out. Nicholas barely alive, though. Fact Fiction got himself a double kill. Maybe they're able to fight it out. 5 members alive for the side of Ono. They might be able to just do this, but there's going to be the Pulse Bomb. A great bubble from Fact Fiction ends up preventing that. And Mofit and T might have just bought themselves another breather, another opportunity. And the reason I freaked out when I saw that Pulse Bomb, guys, is it stuck to a hero that was around by 3 heroes, surrounded by 3. And if that Pulse Bomb would have gone off in a bigger moment, that would have just been it for TSM. But 60% to 99% is TSM is not out of the woods yet, and not quite going to be able to play TSM. They still need to win this map. They still need to win this series. Chase Hill able to take out Torque. That's a big start. Mofit taking a lot of damage. He is going to be able to get the Pulse Bomb off. Will it get a lot of damage? No. Just collateral, as he's going to be looking on a Harblue, trying to get as much damage as possible. Harblue is going to go down to Mofit as Chase Hill ends up taking out JKW. Shake does have the Transcendence, but he critically goes down during it, so he's not able to get it off right now, and it's basically just going to be the remaining two brothers, Nick and Torque, as they're going to respawn and be getting together. Guys, 85% to 99%. Will this come down to the last map of the match point against TSM and Ono? I'm not sure. This is just absolutely crazy. As here we go, action gonna be underway. JKW would take out Mofit as Mofit checks out JKW. Nicholas in the background, he needs to get big kills as Torque is gonna be able to get that kill. Shake doesn't even just mess around, he's gonna immediately channel out that Transcendence, and it looks like this kill feed going so in favor of the side of TSM. I just don't even know if I can say any hope for the side of Mofit and squad. As you guys can see, Zayd is all the way back here. Mofit's their only hope. Point's gonna get flipped, he's gonna be zoned back by Winston, and there is just literally no hope for them, as the side of TSM is going to go ahead and take the series 3-2-1. And they're going to go ahead and move on to the semifinals to go ahead and play against the side of Envious. As I take a short break here from talking to enjoy this play of the game, Fact Fiction, shout out to him as, of course, ex-competitive Dota player in the North American scene. Very strong player in his own respect, and I gotta say, the transition has been good for him. as he was definitely a big shine for his factor. Honestly, most of the players did set up. There was moments where Zayd was doing work. There was a moment where Facts for Fiction was doing work. There was a moment where Mofit was doing work. There was moments where basically every member of the side of Oh No was doing work, but it just wasn't enough, guys. And that's going to be Envious moving along into the upper bracket. And that's going to be it for us seeing them on the stream. So I'm going to go ahead and give you guys that update now. So first things first, let's go ahead and pull up the bracket and refresh so you guys can see what happened. As you guys will see, the side of Envious is going to be taking on the side of Solo Mid, and then below is going to be the other semifinal. All of the semifinals, meaning Envious versus Team and Team Solo Mid, and then the match below that will be on ESL_Overwatch. So if you guys want to go watch Envious, go over to ESL_Overwatch, as well as, I didn't mean to be awesome if you guys kept a multi-stream of this stream, but at the same time, ESL_Overwatch is going to be casting Envious versus TSM, and then the other semifinal, when that's decided sequentially, that'll be there. Meanwhile, here on Twitch TV Dota Raptors, we're going to be jumping down here. I'm going to be looking for another match. Northern Gaming Red should be taking on the winner, I believe, of a loser of Team Liquid versus Cloud9. That's the match that I'm probably going to be going to, guys. We'll find out, though, as I'm going to take a break. That was a long and hectic series. My voice is a little bit tasks there, but I will go ahead and say thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for stopping by. You guys are absolutely amazing. Definitely check out at ESL Overwatch and at Play Overwatch on Twitter, as of course ESL is hosting this and Blizzard is providing the sponsorship as well as the LAN server to be played on. But guys, if you enjoyed this cast, do follow the channel Twitch TV Dota Raptors. You can go ahead and follow me here. I do lots of casting for Overwatch. I do a Stratwatch series, which you can find on youtube.com/user/DotaRaptors. And of course, if you guys want more updates than just the YouTube and the Twitter or Twitch, go ahead and follow me on Twitter at RaptorZOW. That would be awesome, as of course, that's the best way for me to go ahead and get more casting gigs. Something I want to take seriously. If you guys have watched my cast before, I've made it public, made it clear. This is something I want to do as a job in the future. So we'll see if it ends up happening. I'm going to keep working at it. But nonetheless, guys, I'm going to take a break here, get some water, get some actual break in that respect, and I'll be bringing you guys a loser's bracket game for the next one. Again, ESL_Overwatch will be your two semifinals, and then the loser's bracket will be here, will be me, Raptors ZOW, covering all that, guys, for the Atlantic Showdown NA Regionals. We'll be figuring out what's coming up next. Again, thank you so much for tuning in. I'm Raptors, and this is the NA Regionals. We'll be back with more action in just a moment.